Management of cardiac abnormalities after subarachnoid hemorrhage. Cardiac complications are common after subarachnoid hemorrhage and associated with poor outcome. These manifest as ECG abnormalities, elevated cardiac troponin I, and a spectrum of ventricular dysfunction collectively referred to as the neurogenic stunned myocardium NSM syndrome. ECG abnormalities are extremely common after subarachnoid hemorrhage. ST segment changes have been reported in up to 50 of patients, inverted or isoelectric T waves in up to 90, QTC prolongation in almost two-thirds, and cardiac arrhythmias in more than one-third. Elevation of cardiac troponin I occurs in approximately one-third of patients, and left ventricular dysfunction in around 18. The underlying mechanism of neurogenic stunned myocardium NSM syndrome is believed to relate to sympathetic nervous system activation and excessive noradrenaline release from myocardial sympathetic nerve terminals. Left ventricular dysfunction is usually temporary, although some patients require cardiovascular support. Risk factors for the development of neurogenic stunned myocardium NSM syndrome include worse subarachnoid hemorrhage clinical grade at presentation, smoking, and increasing age. Although cardiopulmonary and hemodynamic status should be optimized, no class I data, i.e. from RCTs, exists to guide the management of cardiac abnormalities after subarachnoid hemorrhage. Characterizing cardiac performance using echocardiography and continuous cardiac output monitoring may be useful in guiding therapy in patients with symptomatic neurogenic stunned myocardium NSM syndrome. Dobutamine has been used to increase cardiac output, but the influence on outcomes is unclear. Potassium and magnesium values should be checked and corrected if necessary. Crucially important is the avoidance of delays in securing the aneurysm in patients with ECG and other cardiac abnormalities in the presence of clinical stability.